Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam ma ba'd ayyuhal habati fillah. Imam Al-Albani, rahmatullahi alayhi wa rahmatullahi wasi'ah, was asked, what is your excellency's opinion about the Salafi dawa in general and specifically in Kuwait, Egypt, and Saudi? Imam Al-Albani, rahmatullahi alayhi, responded by saying, I say that unfortunately the Salafi dawa is now in disarray. And I attribute the cause of that to the hastiness of many of the Muslim youth to claim knowledge. So he will have the audacity to pass fatwas and to declare things to be haram and halal before he knows. Some of them, as I have heard on numerous occasions, can't even recite an ayah from the Quran properly, even if the noble mushaf were open in front of them, let alone the fact that he will make many mistakes when simply reading a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and so that the proverb that is well known in some countries is applicable to him. Innahu tazabbib qabla an yatahassarum. He became a raisin before even becoming a sour grape. You know what hasram is? Is the word used amongst you? When a grape starts out, it becomes a green berry. This is what al-hasramu is referred to, and it is very sour. So before he even reaches the stage of being a sour grape, he makes himself out to be a raisin. Thus, for many of these people to prop up their heads and be hasty in both claiming knowledge and writing when they haven't even traversed half the way on the path of to knowledge, is what now unfortunately makes those who attribute themselves to be Salafi, to be themselves the Salafi dawah, split into groups and factions. And so there is no cure for this except for those Muslims to fear their Lord, the Mighty and Majestic, and for them to know that it is not for everyone who starts off seeking knowledge to take the lead in declaring fatwas about things being halal and haram, or declaring hadiths to be authentic or weak, except after a long lifetime, a lifetime in which he practices learning how fatwas are delivered and how verdicts are derived from the book and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in this respect, these callers or Salafis must comply with that third check which I have mentioned before when speaking about beneficial knowledge and righteous actions, saying that beneficial knowledge must be according to the methodology of the Salaf al-Salih. So nowadays, when many of the Islamic callers depart from this check, the third check which Ibn al-Qayyum, may Allah have mercy upon him, indicated in his poetry when he said, knowledge is Allah said and his messenger said, the companion said, and it is not hidden. Not paying heed to what our Salaf al-Salih were upon makes the people go back after having been united to disunity, which separates them as it had done with many Muslims before, turning them into groups and factions, each faction pleased with what it has. This is my opinion of the situation. So if, as we hope, they are sincere, they must cling to the correct knowledge-based principles, and that the person who has not reached the level of having correct knowledge does not have the audacity to, that he keeps himself out of sight from dwelling into that, and he entrusts knowledge to the one who knows it, meaning the scholars. In this regard, there's a narration which has been reported in the books of Hadith. I think it was Abdurrahman ibn Abi Layla radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was one of the major scholars of the Salaf al-Salih. He said, in this mosque, and maybe he was referring to the Prophet's masjid, I met, and then he mentioned a specific number of companions. I forget the number now. So when one of them would be asked, and then someone interjected, 70. Imam Al-Albani responded, maybe it was. I met 70 companions in this mosque. When one of them would be asked a question or asked for a fatwa, he would wish that another one of the scholars from those companions who were present would shoulder the responsibility for it. And the reason for that was because they feared that they would make a mistake, thus as a result would cause other people to fall into making a mistake. So they would wish to not have to take this responsibility, and that someone else would. As for now, then the situation most unfortunately is the polar opposite. And that is because of one reason, which is something I always mention, that this blooming, which we now see for the book and the sunnah and the Salafi dawah, is something new. This blossoming, which they call an awakening, has not been going on for a long time, such that these people can reap the fruits of this awakening or blossoming in themselves, namely by being nurtured on the foundations of the book and the sunnah, and for them to then inundate with this correct nurturing based upon the book and the sunnah others who are around them, calling those closest to them firstly and then those after them. So the cause is that the effects of this dawah have not become apparent because it is new to this time in which we live. For this reason, we find the situation to be the opposite of what Abdurrahman ibn Abi Layla reported about those companions who would be cautious of being asked questions and who would wish that someone else would be asked. And the only reason they would then make an answer and answer a question would be because they knew that it was not allowed for them to hide knowledge. But in the depths of their heart, they used to wish that someone else would bear that responsibility. As for now, in many Salafi gatherings, let alone non-Salafi ones, a person who is assumed to have, has more knowledge than other people present is asked a question. And all of a sudden you will see that so-and-so has started to speak, even though he wasn't asked. And so-and-so has started to speak, even though he wasn't asked. What makes these people do that? It is the love of fame. It is self-centeredness. I am here. I have knowledge, mashallah, about me. This shows that we have not had a Salafi tarbiyah. We have grown up with Salafi knowledge, each according to his efforts and striving towards that knowledge. But as for tarbiyah, then we have not yet acquired it as an Islamic Salafi community. So we are now in an awakening in the terms of knowledge, but we are still not in an awakening of correct upbringing, tarbiyah. That is why many times we find individuals, some callers, that can be benefited from in terms of knowledge, but not in manners, because he brought himself up on knowledge, but was not in a righteous environment, which he was raised from childhood. And for this reason, he lives carrying out the manners which he inherited from that society in which he exists, and which he is found. And it is a society which, without doubt, is not an Islamic one. But he was able to, by himself or with the direction of some of the people of knowledge, follow the path of obtaining correct knowledge. But the effects of this knowledge are not seen in his manners, in his behavior, in his actions. The cause of this manifestation, which we're talking about now, is that we have not matured fully developed in knowledge except a few individuals. And secondly, individuals even more so have not been brought up according to a correct Islamic upbringing. And this is why you will find that many of the beginners in seeking knowledge will prop themselves up as a head, the head of the jama'ah or faction. And it is here that an old piece of wisdom which expresses this manifestation applies. It says, the love of fame will break one's back. So the cause of all this goes back to a lack of correct upbringing on that correct knowledge. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ilman nafir, rizqan tayyiban, wa amalan mutaqabbalan. And may Allah bless Imam Al-Albani with Jannat al-Firdaws for this beautiful piece of nasiha, which is so applicable in this time. And may Allah bless us with the correct tarbiyah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless those people, the translators at Sheikh Al-Albani WordPress. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.